chairman and the vice chair, and I have been voted as vice chair for Liverpool City Region. And I'm also on the audit committee, and we've got a meeting, the first meeting of the audit committee this year, next week. Last year with the environment regeneration, I thought it was very important that we had an update at every one of our meetings. And I think it is important. It's a very fluid situation, as I'm sure all members are aware. I would also like to say to the committee that I would also like to have an update at every one of our committees this year for this new, newly formulated committee of business, if that's agreed. So we'll add that as a standing item to every agenda. Yes, David?
Chair, will that be a written report or a verbal one as we received all last year?
Well, what was happening?
We received, we received only the last couple of days the work that you've done on the selection of the two pieces of work that you've done on buses and the which I received and read today. Now, it would have been helpful to this committee if we realised that was the kind of work that you're doing through the whole of the year, because it goes back to what we were saying with the council, and that other members just don't know what's going on over there, and yourselves. And I did say at full council, all we received in our previous committee, and we received them on again today, is a verbal report.
Dave, that's a fair comment, and that's probably remiss of me, because I'm the link on scrutiny to the council. So I think it's worth adding then to our agenda that I give an update at every one of our meetings on what the scrutiny panel. You're quite right.
We only found out in the email Mike sent to us with the attachment.
That's a fair comment. I'll make sure now at every one of our meetings I'll give an update the way I'm doing now on what we're doing. So, point taken, Dave.
Thank you.
So we've had a training day, and a lot of it was about the European Union, because we, as a Liverpool City region and here in Wirral, we've benefited greatly over the years from funding from the European Union. And now we're in a state of flux, really. And I certainly don't want to get party political. In fact, it isn't party political, is it? Because we have an ad campaign that will make up of all parties. So it's not party political. And the main camp the same. So we're now looking to see where the funding is going to come from that we're going to lose. Now, we were promised by the Brexiteers that the funding would be matched penny for penny. But we'll now have to wait and see whether that's the case. Now, I personally doubt whether it will be matched penny for penny. But we are where we are. We've got to come through it, and we've got to come through it now as a council here in Wales, and as a Liverpool City region. We've got to make the best of what we've got, without a doubt. So that's where we're at the moment. Now, our first meeting was last week, and Joe Anderson came along and did a presentation on the new Metro Mayor. What that will entail and the plans that are being put in place at this very moment, because when we have the election next May for the Metro Mayor, the structure's got to be in place for the Mayor. There's got to be a structure there to support the Mayor. Now, what we're concerned about as a scrutiny committee, and I think we'll as a borough, we've got concerns. We and all the other councils and all the other that. I can't. You've had the report about the work, the two pieces of work we did last year. I think the scrutiny panel, and it's evolved. We started from scratch 2 years ago, and I think we are happy now with what we're doing. At least I feel that after 2 years now, I know what we're supposed to be doing, who we're supposed to be asking questions of. So it's evolving, and I think it's evolving well. But from now till next May, the more that all of us ask questions, if we're not happy with anything that we read, we bring it forward in notices of motion or whatever, and we keep on top of it. It's in all our interests to glean as much information as we possibly can and ask as many questions as we possibly can. And the more difficult the question, the better, really, as far as I'm concerned. If anyone's got any questions, I'll try my very best to answer them.
Safety, it's the first report.
Chair, I made a note on my note in relation to that particular point. We've got to look at the ratio of management to staff and the need to do it properly. I know the questions have been asked before because of the need for it to be done. I'll give you an instance. My youngest daughter works in the bank of my care, who gets done on a 6 monthly basis. So it's nothing that's really, you know, too onerous on managers to ask to do that. Fully concur with the comments you've made in relation. As David said, it's the outstanding one, and I know it is in his report, and it's only been appealing now, and that's coming seriously. We've already said that we're going to ask for the next meeting to have the relevant people to come and discuss these issues. But I won't go any further than that. I think that will be just highlight it, readdress it. There's two that I picked up on in relation to some agents and management list, and it's the maintaining commission roles, strategic role, principal role networks, and maintenance positions. 1% on both of them. Both increased by 0.7%. I take it that's the money that we got, the extra money that we got for potholes over the years. But given that the Cabinet's made a decision that they're only going to spend the revenue that's coming in for highways from the integrated transport block, will we see this stay as it is, or will we see it slowly erode? Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. in the time. You need to have a hospital which can't be combined. Different ones come on at different times. You can walk past one in total darkness, kick it and it'll come on. Whether that's coincidence or not, I don't know. Sorrow Road, Ashby Road, Liso Road, they're on, off, different times. You know, lights do not come on. It's what it is now. This is more than teenage problems. There's something really wrong with the system.
It's a shame Sean Gray has managed to Sean has managed his project and is now our expert in this type of lighting and communication systems that go with it. And we do have some teenage problems with some of the communications. And Sean assures me that we know where they all are, but I will raise the points that you can to make sure we've got those. But certainly, people think the lights are coming on at odd times and it's hardly going to use it. It is what it is now. The theory is that's where I can make sure we get that right. It's these new ones talk to our processes. We should know as a project.
Could I highlight then the A41 from Junction Farm to Newton Road, which is a good long section?
Chair, thank you. Councillor Mitchell, I don't know where of that.
Okay.
Steve. That's your page 40, I see Sam. The usual concern of mine, the full pavilion, which I always treat as a jewel in the crown to the authority of something pressure, but yet it's never gone to the expectations we thought it would. And particularly in this report, the wording is that there's a higher than expected level of income in the number of services which offset an adverse variance of the full pavilion. Do you think we should even be having some sort of more in-depth look at this is going on and on and on, and we don't seem to be improving on something that we thought would be a good improvement and an asset to the council.
Thank you, Chair. I think, yeah, it's an issue, year on year issue, the lawmakers talking about responding to balance its books. The financial position has improved, the manager has improved their position, and there is an in-depth review.
Anyone else? Committee agreed recommendation?
Agreed.
Thank you.
Tracy,
I'm sure we'll get there in the end.
I would just wish we'll think
the Scrutiny Aware programme. Has everybody had a chance to look at what we're having a meeting? When are we having a meeting? We're having a meeting fairly soon with the spokespersons. We need the committee to agree the format of the chair, which is the format of the committee, which is myself as chair, Dave Mitchell, the spokesperson for the Lib Dems, and Steve Williams, the spokesperson for the Conservatives, and I need the committee to agree that. Is that agreed?
Yes,
agreed.
Can I just, if I may, just ask a question on the members' briefing package that came up today? And we've got Ben James, the WAVE programme, and we talked about principles for prioritisation. Are they in any particular order? Those principles for prioritisation, are they laid out in an order of priority?
They're not necessarily in that order, they're the key.
The point I'm making is the topic of principles for prioritisation for rural plans and the second one, public interest.
Yes.
See, I would have thought if they were in prioritisation, public interest would be number one.
Well,
that's why I asked, are they in any order of prioritisation?
They are prioritised. You might agree with the way they're prioritised, Chris, but they are.
And that would be the Scrutiny Office, you said they weren't.
They're the principles of
no. They are prioritised.
Yes. In that order.
As described.
No. That's the question. Is that the order of priorities? Because it doesn't make a difference.
I would suggest they are.
Okay, well, can I move the member then, Chair, to the rear programme that public interest becomes the top priority?
You can, certainly.
Yeah.
You got a
second
there? Yeah. Okay. All those in favour, can you just say that again?
Based on the members of the Scrutiny Committee members' briefing pack, page 8 and 12, item 4 of the web programme, the principles for prioritisation, I would move that the one listed at second on the list, public interest, is moved to top of the list above Wirral Plan.
I don't know how that works.
Who seconded?
Did
we get a second?
We've
got a recommendation. We've got a second. very much. Thank you very much for your participation tonight. Thank you. And save Jerry.